One of the most important aspects of our physical health is proper breathing. In fact, studies show that the leading cause of cancer, stroke, and heart disease is lack of oxygen. And while there's lots of reasons for that, one thing that we can take a moment to consider is our stress level. All of us, with so much going on in our families, friends, life, work, in general, we get stressed and busy and focused. And what happens a lot of times is our breathing becomes very shallow. Studies show that most people only use about 10% of their lung capacity. So let's do a quick little test here. Go ahead and place one hand on your chest and one hand on your stomach. And just take a couple deep breaths. Now as you do that, notice what happens. Does your chest rise? Does your chest and belly rise? Well, what should happen is that your chest and belly both rise as you inhale and fall as you exhale. Also, the rib cage, it should expand. So when you're doing that, as you're taking the full deep breath, you're stretching your lungs, therefore strengthening them. So the more we practice that, the more natural it becomes throughout our day, when we're not even thinking about it, but also when we're exercising, so many different things throughout our day. It's important to just kind of take note and notice our breathing, particularly whenever we're stressed or when we're focused. So many different benefits with proper breathing, which includes decreased stress, because it helps our mind. So it helps us to handle our emotions better, to think clearer. So it's going to help with our focus, with our work, with our studies, whatever we're doing. It also helps to improve our metabolism, improves our skin, in fact, all of our organs all function as they should. And you'll feel better because everything's working better. Another important point I want to mention about our breathing is the length of your inhale and the length of your exhale. So another little test you can do is to silently count the length of your inhale and then the length of your exhale. Most likely, you're going to have an even count there. Same length as you inhale and same as you exhale. But what you want to get to a point is that your exhale is twice as long as your inhale. So for example, starting out, you might inhale for 2 or 3 seconds. So you want to try to exhale or even control the length of your exhale while you're practicing for 4 to 6 seconds. And so by doing that, when you're inhaling, you're filling your body with oxygen, helping everything to work properly. And then as you're exhaling, the purpose of that is to cleanse our lungs and to rid our lungs of toxins. So again, just by practicing, you are just encouraging that natural process. So those are the two tests for you. Check your breathing, and throughout your day, maybe just check it. You know, maybe place your hand on your chest and stomach, take a nice full inhale, see what happens, make sure that you're not taking those shallow breaths. Take care.